cup of coffee.
All right, guys, so here what I've got in my hand is about a cup of water, warm, almost hot water, with about 2 tablespoons of baking soda or sodium bicarbonate. What this is going to do is allow the wood burner to work.
Okay, guys, with this next part, cannot stress enough how safe you need to be. This is super dangerous. You're messing with life and death here. High voltage is no game. Please take all the safety precautions that you can. The safety things. Be safe. Enjoy. Have fun.
Okay, so hey guys, so basically what I've done now is I've taken my pencil here and lightly sketched out the rough shape of the tree that I want to burn. Then I've taken my sodium bicarbonate solution. You can see some of it settled out. But I've taken that and I've painted the start of my tree. You can see that I haven't done all of it, but that's just because I want to direct my burn. Now you can see that this wet section is now the conductive section. The electricity will not flow into these side areas. I'm gonna get it set up and start burning here. So now that I've got everything set up, I've got my leads here. Of course the power is turned off, unplugged and turned off. Double checking everything. Okay. Okay, and I tripped the power. So as it goes, I'm pretty unhappy with how that started. So I'm going to reapply here. Little techniques, you can add more near the leads to prevent it from burning as fast. And that's what I want. One thing I cannot stress enough is when you have the high voltage power turned on, you do not want to touch any part of it. You do not want to touch the leads. You do not want to touch the wood. You do not want to touch the wires. I've got it on an insulating board underneath. You want to stay away. This is lethal high voltage electricity and it will kill you. Please be careful if you're going to be doing this. Okay, so you're going to see me turn it off and on a lot. I really want to get the proper burn. However, I do kind of like how this is starting, so I'm going to let it continue. Since I like the way this is starting, I'm going to get some close-up on the electricity here. Okay, so we are back, and what I think I haven't shown is the bleaching of this wood. All I did was take some regular house household bleach, and I just painted it right over top, let it dry overnight. What that did was it took away the darkness of the sodium bicarbonate solution. You can definitely see the difference now. Basically had like a shadow before, and now it's just completely uniform. What I'm doing now is mixing up the resin. Got my pigment here, some backup colors, and we'll see how this turns out. It has a little bit of bonus beam here, some acrylic pours that my talented mom have done. Some of these are just absolutely fantastic. Okay, sweet. So I'm stirring up the last few seconds of this resin, mixing it up together. Then, like I said, that's the downside to this Fama wood. Total mixing time of 12 minutes, according to the instructions. Okay, now let's add our pigment. I'm using a pigment called Atlantic Blue. Can see it there. Let's see here. Let's see what this does. Oh wow, that's an incredible blue. It's a little bit lighter on in person. On camera, it looks pretty dark. Pouring it into my Fractal Burn tree here. Starting the big cracks. Alright, I like the way this blue looks already. Thank you. you have it. Start to finish, the metallic blue wood lightning bolt.
Say hello to Cozy, everyone. What do you think, Coz? Do you like it? Coz, you like it? Huh? Huh, Coz? Do you like it? I think she likes it, you guys. The ultimate reward, if Coz likes it, it's immediate success. Coz, shout out the channel. No? Okay. That's a good girl. That's a good girl. She likes it, you guys.